All right, bro, shut the fuck up.
Thank you for tuning in to my Webster's Laboratory 2 by Chris Webby. Today I'm joined by...
VS Hero.
And I would like to start out every album review talking about the artist and my disclaimer about how much I actually know about the artist, because I read a lot of reviews where people clearly don't know the artist, or you can tell it, but they don't state it out loud. And so I just want to state my record with Chris Webby. So if you're a diehard Webby fan and you know some more stuff about him than me, then you know that might be true and take my opinion with a grain of salt. So my background with Webby is I've seen his name the last couple years blowing up. I never really gave him a chance till now, but I have heard, I've had a bunch of his songs on my phone before. I've had the one with Tech N9ne and Jaren. I've had the one with Ritz. I've had the one with Snother Product and John Connor. The other one with Snother Product, or the other one with John Connor. I've had, you know, a couple tracks off Chemically Imbalanced. You know, I've always seen his name everywhere, and I respected his hustle, and I saw that he was going on tour with Tech, and I should have listened to him then, but I always waited. Well, I was sleeping on him, and it was definitely a regrettable decision, but now I'm here. I've been slumping the shit out of this album or mixtape, and I've been listening to his album a little bit now too, and I'm going to go through his back catalog over time, and I am glad to finally be a part of Chris Webby's fan base. Hero, what's your experience?
Yeah, I don't have too much backstory with Webby. I haven't listened to much of his stuff. I've listened to a couple songs off Chemically Imbalanced whenever Aaron told me I listened to it, and then I listened. This is the first product I've listened to start to finish. Is this mixtape, and yeah, I've been bumping the hell out of it. This mixtape.
So,
I guess we'll get started.
Yeah, what's the first track?
Number one is the intro song to the mixtape, which is just Webby's Lab 2.
And I had to get Bootlegger to tell me the intro. I know the first one was Rugrats, but I didn't know the second one was Sopranos, and I'm still not sure what the third sound is on there, but that was always like the intro.
I knew the first two, but I didn't know the third one.
And then the
produced
beat said
by JP on the track.
And he sampled the Breaking Bad theme song, which is fucking absolutely dope. And this was like, you know, one of the first songs I gravitated towards. And my joke has been that he sounds like DMX. He channeled his DMX flow on this song because it was gritty, graspy, and he was, you know, like barking half the time. But it was a really raw and rough song, and I really liked it the way he was spitting on it. And this was a great fucking intro and start to the album.
Yeah, it was an amazing intro and start to the album. The beat is really good. I never watched Breaking Bad, so it didn't give me an orgasm when he sampled that.
You're missing out. Is there any lyrics that stand out to you?
I mean, it's not really any particular lyrics on this that stand out. It's just a dope song talking about how he's back again.
I liked the Bandicoot of Dat Piff line. And then he ended the first verse saying he's ready to crash it again. I really liked that play on words. I liked a lot of Bandicoot, Crash Bandicoot, and a lot of Rugrats at the intro and a lot of pop culture references. It reminded me a lot of XV, so I liked that shit.
How he stated when everybody looks him up, it's those stupid photo shoots from like 2008.
Mm-hmm.
And he says when I was saying some chemically fueled ludicrous statements. Thought that was pretty cool.
And what motivates him isn't trying to get Lamborghini or jewelry. It's that he's sick of falling in debt with some Indian guy from American Express. I like that lyric. I liked that he tried to keep it humble and didn't, like, he states his motivations, and it's not, like, you know, cold and, like, arbitrary.
He talks material. About how music is... It's his antidepressant. It's more than just mm-hmm. music to him. It's a way of life. Really good.
And I liked. And then the second verse is really fucking good. Right at the end, he's like, hip hop's dead, like Nas said. And it's this. I quote, I'm feeling like I'm out of the loop, and it's an inside joke. Wait, you're serious? You're actually serious? You think this guy's dope? And I agree with 100% on him. That's how I feel when I hear anybody listen to the music nowadays. So that lyric's always stuck with me. I always really enjoyed the way he ends this
fucking
song.
That is a very good lyric. Anything else you want to say?
I think
before
that's
we
it.
Move on, Aaron?
Yeah, go ahead.
Moving on to number two is Dat Piff, which is a freestyle or a free verse. However you want to say it.
Oh,
it says on the mixtape free verse, produced by DJ Newmark. And Aaron hates on this because it's a freestyle. Yeah, and I really like it. It doesn't feel like a freestyle. I really like it. He has some good lines in this talking about how, like, what the fuck's happened? All I'm hearing from the college kids is EDM, Hillary Clinton's dabbing. Like, it's a really good, I like it.
I don't have a problem with it. It's just this mixtape had such great songs that I don't want to waste my time listening to a freestyle. That was all my complaint was.
Talks about one lyric where he says, they pick apart my every lyric like a frog in biology. He has some good lines in this.
Yeah, there was that line about Donald Trump that you always like.
Oh, yeah. Can I give a fuck? Maybe, but I swear that you'll never see it like Donald Trump on a prayer mat. That's really good.
And this one also has that Spotify really line. Well, thanks for that. Like that 1,000th of a dollar guy.
Thanks for that, like 1,000th of a dollar guy, yeah. He has some really good lines in this.
Yeah, that he mentioned.
I listened to it. It doesn't feel like a freestyle.
No, he shits on Spotify and people that listen on Spotify. I like that.
But move on to number 3, which is Knocked Down. It is produced by...
Do you see the music video for this one?
Use of All Trades. I have not seen the music video before.
This is that pirate one. I didn't really care for the music video, but it was whatever. And, I mean, I didn't really care for the sample. You know, Bootlegger likes it because he listens to music from the 90s.
I don't like the song they sampled, so this one just kind of was mad to me because I don't like that. Just constantly repeating, I get knocked down, but I get up again. I mean, it's kind of annoying.
The verses were fine. You know, this is more that party style song, so this one he usually misses me with. But, you know, I still respected it. You know, it was good and shit. The beat slumped and hit hard. But it was just, you know, not really my cup of tea, so I usually skip it also.
Yeah, me either.
But, you know, there's clever punchlines and shit mixed in it. You know, like, where is it? But you won't see me on Sunday like a mailman. I'm on my Chumbawamba, clutch a cup of vodka shipped in from Mother Russia. Like, you know, silly goofy lines, but a party song nonetheless. Well, there's a Johnny Bravo reference in the song also, so that's always good.
Johnny Bravo reference. I didn't watch much Johnny Bravo, so I wouldn't.
I don't know, it was goofy, so I watched it. That's a great... I don't fucking know, man. He was silly.
Number 4 is Ignition, produced by Jitta on the track.
Featuring
Dave East.
I've seen his name, and he put out a mixed or EP or something literally like yesterday, and I'm still not interested enough even after hearing his verse on this. He's on the freshman cover. Songs? No, he's only on one.
He's only on this track?
Yeah. This song, the beat hits hard. I like that. The bass goes hard, and I don't know. I like it slumping in the car. It's a good song for hitting in the car, though, but, you know, it's about chicks, you know, half the time, the other half about cars, but I didn't have a big problem with it, so I like this song.
Yeah, it's slump. It's just not my style of song. I don't really care for songs where all I do is talk about women and cars and shit.
See,
I ain't got no beef for the song. It's just not my style.
See, I don't know. This was also one of the first songs I gravitated towards because it was catchy, and it had good bass in it. So I did listen to this one quite a few at the start. So that was a little different between me and him, me and this trusty guy. Well,
the first song I gravitated towards was Dat Piff. That's what I listened to. Because it was really good. I liked it. I didn't give a fuck that it was a freestyle.
Any lyrics stand out to you? I'm the cracker with the flavor you ain't seen since Townhouse. It's a bunch of, you know, clever punchlines and shit. But go ahead, Corey.
Anything else you want to say?
No, it's just, you know, a good song, but, you know, nothing like... I can talk about songs that I don't like. I like and respect, but I can sit here and talk all day about some of the other ones on this album.
And so, yeah, I feel the same way. Moving on to number 5 is On My Way, produced by JP on the track.
Oh, anyway, so where to start on this song? Is this the one with that weird auto tune on his voice a little bit?
I believe so. I think this is why
I liked the subject matter because it was more of a motivational type song, big time, and I enjoy it, but I don't like that effect he put on his voice. That one little turned me off a little bit, but I did enjoy some of the punchlines and the wittiness for, you know, being positive in life. I did enjoy that.
I enjoyed the talking matter and how it's a motivational song, but I didn't like the auto-tune he put on his voice. That's what kind of made me not listen to it as much. I've only listened to it like 2 or 3 times.
I could have swore
But
there was a, I'm looking through the lyrics. I could have swore there was a line in here I really liked, and I can't find it right now. But there's just a bunch of them. If you don't take from the lessons you're learning, or the money isn't worth earning if you're not taking from the lessons you're learning. There's good lines, just positive motivational shit, to not like all get all bogged down in the day-to-day grind that, you're still taking something away from it. I liked that. Navigating life while that fire is burning. Good fucking lines.
yeah,
Deep in your
that's
soul
good.
before you get old, and live with regret for not reaching your goals. No. Just keep up that fight when your back's on the ropes.
I'm still reaching for the skyline, got my hand raised, tell me teacher when will I shine, because I've been sitting on the bleachers and on the sidelines. Spent my whole life following the guidelines. It's really good. Yeah, I just didn't like that auto-tune he put on his voice. There's a couple of songs that have. I mean, that's just like the same thing with that Bobby and Whitney song. The reason I didn't like it. Moving on to number 6 is Sativa.
Get it.
Produced by
So, Juice of All
Juice of All
Trades
Trades.
featuring
Yeah.
B Real, Demerick, and that singing dude, Zakari. Now, we have to start this up. My dude D Nick hates on Demerick because he did a Team Backpack cipher and fucking he got on the mic and he's like, Demerick! And D Nick always clowns him for it. So every time I see Demerick, I always laugh. And Demerick also reminds me of fucking Futuristic because they're both very, very, very average rappers, but for some odd reason are everywhere. So. And then I have no beef with B Real. Every time I see B Real, though, I always think of the Eminem lyric. But that's just because, I don't really listen to, I didn't really listen to Cypress Hill, and I didn't really listen to weed music. So, and it's funny because it's a weed song. I like the beat to this song a lot. The hook is good, and I liked Webby's verse. When I want to smoke some of that good weed, maybe I'll listen to this song. But usually I skip after the first verse, which is Webby's.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't have anything to say. I haven't really listened to the song because I don't really listen to songs about weed because I don't really smoke weed
So there's
that
a know the
often. So.
difference between a sativa and an indica. We need Storm for this. Apparently, a sativa
Yeah, we do.
helps you be more energized and more creativity, and indica makes you tired and want to eat and be lazy. So we need more of that sativa apparently.
Fucking storm, man.
I wondered
Moving
what he
on
meant in that video
to
when he talked about no more intricates. That's fucking funny. That came full
number
circle.
7 is Brass Tacks, produced by Juice of All Trades, featuring Danimal Lecter.
What are your thoughts on this guy, Corey? Go ahead. I'm sucking his dick.
My favorite verse on as far as features go. He dropped the best one, period, in my opinion. He dropped the best one.
It was
I
good and
mean,
I
I'll
liked
suck his
it,
dick if you
but
don't
I
like him.
disagree that he can that name my top 10 rappers. He'll eat them. He'll eat like five of them, or eat five of them like some steakums, and then me can hang with the other five. And it just always makes me
He
laugh when I hear
said
that lyric.
five, whether or not I can take him. But he chopped, which kind of surprised me. Only dude on there to chop. But I really liked his verse. Like I said, my favorite verse as far as a feature goes. The song's beat's really good too. I really like the beat to this song,
And
even though it ain't got too much bass to it.
Webby did a great verse. I liked the lyric where he's like, "I'm a
Webby did a
monster
really good
with the
verse.
ink. When I'm writing, they call me Mike Wazowski." I really liked that one. I liked the Monsters, Inc. reference.
That's really good.
I really also liked. I've been the best in the burp since my third CD. Still, I'm underrated, like making the Purge
Like making the
PG.
Purge PG. Yep.
I was singing
Yeah,
this to my head.
Webby did some really good verses on this
For some
mixtape.
odd reason, you and C-Plant really liked the Ronda
And like Ronda Rousey, I'm smacking bitches and
Rousey
acting malicious. I don't know, it's just
line.
funny.
Y'all
The
dudes
way he
love that
says it
lyric. So.
Nowhere, he just says, and like Ronda Rousey, I'm smacking bitches. It's funny.
He said, his chick skinny, his piff sticky, my whip's pretty.
He's
I've been
stirring up
busy
trouble
stirring
in
up
Sin
trouble in Sin
City.
City. Oh, and he goes on to say, I'm eating rappers like I got the appetite of Chris Christie. I thought that was a good lyric, too. Oh, and he spits gritty. Also put that up there. And then he talks about Eminem.
Yeah, he references Eminem. And Eminem was my favorite, can't you tell, when I grabbed the serrated blade and stabbed myself in the face with it.
You don't.
I love the Christian Mingle line.
Yeah,
that's really
you
good.
Won't need the internet to witness Christian Mingle.
Listen, Christian Mingle, that's a really good line.
Yeah, it was a good punchline. I like that one too.
Make these bitches single, my dick will tingle. It's really good. Anything else you want to say?
No, I think move on.
Number 8 is Inebriated, and I absolutely love this song.
J. Michelle did a great hook.
She did an amazing hook, produced by Teddy Roxpin. But so, the hook was amazing, and the beat is really good.
Man.
And Webby dropped some dope verses.
So, this was the song with the line about, like, I don't care what any... You can do whatever... I wouldn't... How's the lyric go? Where he talks about drug use?
He said,
I don't support drug usage. I would never tell my
now,
fans...
Now, I don't support drug use. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Continue.
I would never tell my fans that they should do it, but any adult can do whatever they want and live life however he or she chooses. Really liked
it's a
that
beautiful
lyric.
Line. It's a perfect
yep.
line. Some, like... Yep. Summed up a message that everybody argues about in, what, 4 bars? Like, it's perfect. It's a really good line, and it's straight to the point. It's the best line in this song, in my opinion.
Really it's a really line. Good fucking chill song just to listen to in the car with good bass in it, and I really like the way they did the hook together. And
the hook is really good.
It hits on a good subject matter that... I just really like the way he did that second verse at the start.
Yeah, it's really good. Move on to number 9, which is Full Steam Ahead. Produced by, as soon as I can scroll down, C-Lance, featuring Futuristic.
So we'll talk about y'all doing Futuristic.
I don't really care for Futuristic. I don't really listen to him.
I went back and listened to Blinded by Locksmith featuring Jaren and Futuristic just to double check. And yeah, Futuristic, I still don't like him. His verse on that was whack. He's always been whack. I still stand by that claim.
I haven't really listened to this song too much. There's something about it that I didn't like. Other than Futuristic.
I liked Webby flowing all over this one. This was where he started chopping a little bit on this one. And C-Lance did a really good beat on it. Some of the lyrics that stand out.
I think it was the hook. I didn't really like the hook on this one.
I like the hook. It was probably because you're singing. You hate anything singing.
I don't hate anything singing, bro.
where is it? Like Em and Tech were spitting, so check the rhythm. I think that was a... Was that a Speed Home reference? Maybe.
I believe so.
Anyway. Yeah, it is.
I mean, I need to listen to the song again.
Yeah, he was chopping on that, man, in his fucking reference to Em and Tech on Speed'em and check the rhythm. Man, he killed that fucking... He float all over this track. Man, I really liked this. I really like his verse on this. I need to edit out Futuristics first. There's also a Bojack,
need to listen to
Bojack
the song
reference.
Again.
Going green, so I'll get a Prius candy painting. Driving through your campus waving as the fans are waiting. Or is that Futuristic? No, that was Webby, sorry.
Yeah, I need to listen to it again. Well, the first time I heard it, there was something about it I didn't like, but...
I think the key to the song is his fucking flow, man. He killed it. I also liked the hitting the pedal since I was 11 playing Twisted Metal. Because the kid is freaking mental. Spit until I pop or rip a vessel in my neck while I whip a rental. I'm running up the mileage so much that if I return it, they'd make me buy it. That line stuck out for some odd reason. Not sure why, but... I just fucking love the way he flowed over this track.
I need to listen to it again.
You need to.
Number
8. It's a good one, man.
I need to.
It's a fucking good one.
I've been in the car a lot, so I've only been listening to songs that are good for while you're in the car. That's why I haven't heard songs.
That's a good one to slump in the car because it's about pedal to the floor by going fast and he's chopping on it. And then just skip futuristics verse like I do.
Next one is Questionnaire produced by Kato.
So this kind of comes like a, like, you know, like a part two of like his stand up song, more socially conscious political video or song. And I listened to Stand Up a couple times, really enjoy that song off Chemically Imbalanced. And so Questionnaire's kind of piggies off that. And there's a lot of good fucking questions he asked in this, and that could be a whole fucking topic for like a whole video. So,
yeah.
But he just asks a bunch of socially conscious questions. Go ahead, Hero. Which ones stand out to you?
I mean, there's so many. He just jumps from topic to topic.
Like he talks about.
He talks about why are we killing Mother Nature for the paper? Why is everything extinct or critically endangered? Why we have found a way to live together?
Why does this younger generation hardly ever seem to care? Why did all the older generations let their greediness destroy the world? The world around us for money, and then they leave this to us. And what is money really? Why do we need it? Right? Do you use it to plug your ears at night, or so you can sleep at night?
This one was really good to me. And why do big pharmaceutical companies have us by these puppet strings? So now we need a pill for every fucking thing. That was really good.
Very good one. Where is it? Why do they? Okay, I guess I have a better. Why are there politicians? I guess the better question is, why don't they ever listen? Why do they always have to lie to us? Why does the news just try to stir the fear inside of us? Why do they really have? What do they really have to hide from us? Why are blind men leading other blind men? There's a bunch of good lyrics. Man, I would just sit here and talk about this because, like, Jimmy Dore's been talking about that lately on his thing about how politicians kind of, like, the Democratic Party trying to make you vote for them out of fear, how the news is puts a spin on everything, yeah. and the corruption there. There's a lot of good points on this. This is just scratching the surface for a whole fucking podcast about politics, man. And, oh, man, I would love to do that.
I love this one.
Go ahead.
And really, what is a race? Because I don't see nobody winning.
Very
How's
good
anybody
one.
Different? This is my questionnaire. I really love that line.
My favorite line, and I think about this because I work in the hood, and so it's very true. Why are kids having babies? I love that line.
I knew you were. I looked at that line and I said Aaron's going to cover it. So I, just
I love that line because man, everybody's fucking pregnant that comes in, man.
Everybody they has like, kids. Oh like everybody.
Oh, and I just like look at
I love
it. And I'm...
the... Go ahead.
I just look at it because I'm fucking 22, man, and like our goal right now is coming up to like that California Dreaming song to piggyback off that. But we kind of have a goal to move out somewhere west, and live life and have a little bit of fun. And I'm like, yo, man, having a kid is not at all something I want to do. So why people want to do that at fucking in their teenage years is just absolutely mental to me.
Dude, I'm not joking when I tell y'all whoever watches this video. When I look around my classroom when I'm in school. They all have kids. And I'm 17.
Oh.
I'm a senior in high school and everybody has kids. It's ridiculous. I love the start of the third verse, too, where he says, why do kids do drugs? Wait, why do I do them?
That was a good
and
one,
I know
too.
It'll catch up to me and leave my life ruined. So why do I find myself drinking and pill popping? Is it for fun anymore or am I just running from my problems? I love that as well. Like,
oh,
he just
I like
jumps
the,
from top of the topic. It's really good.
I like the line, why don't we tax televangelists? I always like that one because I agree, but I agree about not letting religion be tax-free. But that's also a side point. But I always really like that lyric.
The hook was really good, too. It was just simple, and it let all of his verses do the talking instead of the hook getting in the way and trying to be something crazy. You know what I mean? It was just simple. He just says, this is my questionnaire, and then it goes into the next verse.
Mm-hmm.
Let all his verse do the talking, which I thought was cool. Next track, which is number, 11, is Imperfect. Produced by Juice of All Trades, featuring Jay Michelle.
Another good fucking hook by her.
Really
I love
hook.
The fucking hook, man. I really do. I fucking loved how it starts out like singing, and then for the second time around, She flows a little bit on the singing. And I just really like the way that was done. And it gets it
It's
a
honestly
little bit...
one of the few hooks that repeat the same little phrase that I actually like. Because I don't really like hooks that just keep repeating the same thing over and over again. But I like this one. I like the way she did it.
It was really fucking well done. This is another track that I listen to nonstop. I love the beat. I love the flow. I love the subject matter. I wish more people did fucking songs that are deep in subject matter. I wish they did them more as, like, you know, a goal. Like, more up tempo than slow. Like, I can fucking bump a song like this. I can't bump a song like The Noose. Like, for how good it is, I get it. But I'd rather, you know, I like Retrogression. That one goes a little bit harder than Noose.
Fragile, like, songs like
you
that.
You know, like, Fragile goes a little bit harder, and it's a very deep song. Like, I need songs, like, I like the subject matter, but I don't think you always have to do them fucking slow.
You don't have to do a super slow song, You can do an upbeat song and still
I was listening to fucking, Locksmith has done some slow songs that are too slow, but he's done other deep songs that are good tempo. So, I mean, just like on his last album, On Lofty Goals, like, you know, some of them are really good, really deep, and they went decently hard. You know, hardest song ever, I think, had a good tempo to it. I think that this song also, man, if you do it like this, man, I'll fucking listen to that shit on repeat, because this song goes so fucking hard. The beat's
really good. This song is really good. I love the topic matter. The beat's really good. The hook is amazing. Once again, it's another song where you can just go in depth about each verse.
I would say that this is my favorite song off the album, by far. Like, I just absolutely love this song.
I don't know, man. It's close. I really love this song, but I really love Questionnaire.
I love the flow he did for this one, man. Oh, I love this fucking song, man. The subject matter goes in. The subject matter is about, you know, that he has some... he's imperfect. He's got insecurities and anxieties. He's like, let me tell you about
it. It's like what you said about Jane. You can tell he's a real person.
Yeah.
You can tell he's an actual human with problems, and he shows it in his music, which you don't get from a lot of other people.
He talks about that, I used to go and roll a J, but even that don't work anymore. They just never seem to go away. Need some Novocaine to control the pain. And now these motherfuckers know the name. I thought they'd make it better, but they made it, but it's worse. Maybe it's too late to ever hope for change, so I'm saying. Some other lyrics that stuck out from this song are... I like the lyric where he's like, what was it, that all the chicks in his class never liked him, so that's why he's talking about all the chicks he's having sex with now. That was a great put in perspective. Yeah. There's this problem in hip-hop about, you know, songs about rapping about chicks. Well, he literally says in this one, he's like, well, it's kind of, it was built like that because of nature or nurture type thing. I don't, like, he's not that type of person. It's just because he got rejected by chicks that it's a form of dealing with it now to deal with the emotional scarring that it's left. It's fucking very clever that he put it in this song, and it kind of puts a new grasp on if you hear him rap about a song about chicks, such as, what was it? One of the further ones up, I'm blanking, but if you hear him talk about it, it could just be because of the emotional scarring that it left. I thought it was fucking amazing the way he put it into this song and explained it.
The way he put it into his perspective, yeah. Because, I mean, Jaren did something similar on his album where he said, women, liquor, and alcohol, or something like that. That, like, when he wakes up, he feels like there's something he must obtain, you know what I mean? Like, he put it in his perspective on that, and then Webby did it in his perspective on this. Talks about the reason, like you said, he talks about women because all the women just ignored him in high school. It's really good.
And there's also a Boba Fett lyric in here, too, so... I don't know. I like that lyric too. But I fucking love this song.
We'll move on to number 12, which is Can't Complain, produced by Juice of All Trades. Amazing song. Let me just say that right.
I like this song too.
It's amazing.
It's a good up tempo, happy song.
The beat is amazing.
It's so weird that this song comes after Imperfect. I felt like Jurassic Park and this song should have been swapped. Like, I don't know. I don't like the song right after that one. Because Imperfect is so, like, just, like numbing. And then this one's like, oh, no, everything's perfect. I was like, what? But I mean, I listen to them back and forth, and Bootlegger likes to make the joke because this sample's fucking 80, what was it, 8 or 96 Degrees or whatever the boy band is thing that did one of their songs. He's like, oh, you listening to that? I'm like, shut up, Jeff.
But I love this song. I listen to this song every time I'm in the car. It's just a feel-good song with an amazing beat that anybody can listen to. And it makes them feel happy, you know what I mean?
Yeah. He says, really moving good. On up from... Oh, wait, no. Something else. Sorry. What are your thoughts on Annoyed's verse?
I didn't have no problem with his verse. I like his... what is it? His punchline about the McDonald's thing.
I like the McDonald's
I got him annoyed like ba-ba-ba-ba-ba or something like that. That's really good. I didn't have no problem with his verse. I mean, nothing.
He's aight.
This is spectacular. It's just kind of there.
There's a missile command reference by Webby. this shorter
he
verses.
He flows really good on that part where you're talking about.
Man. He fucking kills this fucking song. Kills a lot of this, man. When he's flowing and shit, man, to match his fucking lyrics. Oh, it's a great combination, man. His punchlines are really fucking clever.
I'm trying to find that part that you're talking about, because that part's really good.
What? Back when nobody was giving a damn, they were shooting me down like Missile Command. So I pictured a plan. When I needed a dollar, I sat up at night and envisioned a grand. Now I'm getting a tan with my kicks in the sand and a spliff in the sand and a chick with no pants with a beautiful crib and a bottle of Jamie. What else can I say? I cannot complain.
Yeah, man, really good. That whole verse is really good.
It's fucking dope.
I started with nothing, so something is so. Like.
Mm-hmm.
The hook's really good.
Oh, and he goes, on websites they cite web the sight of the blind could see. There's no chance of denying me. I'll collect my own goddamn finder's fee. I like that lyric too. But,
Yeah.
He collects his own finder's fee. I like
whiskey bottle, bag of weed. He's got everything he need.
Can't complain. No.
It's such a good song. We'll go on to number 13, which is Jurassic Park.
No.
Produced by JP on the track.
I like this one. The beat goes really fucking hard. I like the lyrics on it. I like the punchlines. I don't have a big problem with the hook like Hero does. But
I don't have a problem with the hook. Like it's me. Just after a while that nah. That kind of gets to me after a while. It's not that I got no beef with it. I still listen to it. It's a really good song. Just after a while, that kind of gets on my nerves.
I like the combination of the lyrics going with the theme of Jurassic Park and how he talks about like how he's a reptilian from the Cretaceous. From the Cretaceous, I've written pages on how to make music, from minimum wages to killing these stages. I honestly offer the children a blueprint. How to do this shit, how to do that shit, how to crash that piff, how to be in tune with all of my fans from all over the Atlas. You don't respect that, then I'm gonna lose it. And he goes, he says, see, I've been around here since the comet crashed with the Velociraptors, no way that I'll give in yet. I don't like the Pee Wee Herman line. But I guess maybe because, I don't know.
I like the line where he talks about, you got some plays on SoundCloud, bitch. That was going to be my joke.
Oh, my joke was going to be,
I was
here.
Rapping in the
Since
goddamn
we're
going to
talk about this song,
cool.
I wanted to let you know that, I was going to let you know that that podcast we did for Destiny got some views on SoundCloud. And then you're supposed
that
to respond. Yeah, and then you're going to say, that's cool, kid, because I was getting views back on YouTube. Oh my god! I don't know. It was a good joke. I forgot. I was gonna make a joke about the SoundCloud podcast.
Such a fag.
And then that he also got bars on more bars on more bars, and that he was supposedly a triple threat. But if we're talking about bars and being a triple threat, I still think Chino XL is the best line ever about that. Fucking lying, man. I can't even remember how it goes.
Raising the bar while you're raising the bar.
Yeah, he's like, he's drinking alcohol while he's lifting weights at the same time writing raps. And he's like, so I got bars on bars on bars. Or I'm raising the bar while raising the bar while raising the bar. I was like, oh my god. It's like the greatest fucking lyric. Man, that shit was amazing. I like that he's like spitting like a Dilophosaurus, many verses and a lot of chorus. Man, his flow on this shit was clean. And I've seen a bunny rabbit, in a race go fast, but I'm thinking more like the tortoises. Bunch of fucking dinosaur references on this. Oh, jeez. Any lyrics you like also? MySpace, SoundCloud.
I like the part where he talks about in the 50 show tour across the U.S. All I'm asking for you is respect. I put my sweat and my blood and some tears have been shed while I've been on my path. Thought that was really good.
Oh, and when I said to you, address me as Captain, you lightweight, I was referencing this song, but nobody ever got it.
I got it. I just don't. I just don't like your whack joke.
I thought it was really addressing me as Captain Lightweight Corey. So that was my.
I get half your jokes. I just ignore them because some of them are so bad.
This is also the song where he said that from when I started to rocking with Tech on a 50 show tour across the U.S. There was a Tech reference. Yeah, you know. Yeah. It's like Tech said on Irregular. He's like, if there's a blood and gore message, I'll sure catch it. I'm like, if there's a Tech 9 reference, I'll sure catch it. anytime anything related to Strange Music, I'm like, I got this shit.
One too. By the giant reptilian tracks, I've survived while I've watched others go extinct and become just a thing of the past.
Dope.
Thought that was a really good line.
And
we'll go on to the next freestyle, 14, like which is Feel the Burn, produced by DJ Premier.
Oh, DJ Premier. Is this like, this gotta be a freestyle or something?
Yeah, it's a freestyle.
Over it's the Premier Feel the beat, Burn though.
Freestyle.
Yeah, I know what it is, I'm just saying. It's over a Premier beat. This is the one where he's like, it's my favorite lyric, and started at the end. He's like, I'm like Senator Sanders mixed with a fucking Charmander. So either way, you're going to feel the burn.
I love that line. Feel the
burn. It's a good line.
Such a good line.
I remember when this freestyle came out, and it was before I even started listening to Webby, though, before I listened to Laboratory 2. And I clicked it. I watched it. And I was like, meh. He didn't talk about Bernie enough for me. I was like, fuck, I should have got into him then, too. I fucked up, man. But the beat is taken from
Tom Hardy and Ledger up in the city jail. Fuck Bill, I'm already down in hell chilling.
But like I said, do you remember when Dylan used to do the Marvin the Martian impersonation?
Yeah, Space Jam ball and a Marvin the Martian. That line, is that what you're referencing?
Yeah, I was reading that. I was just saying, you remember when Dylan used to do that because he thought it was funny and that was like the lamest thing ever?
I love the and you know we blunt sparking. I was lower than Ben Carson's. I like that.
That was a dope line too.
Thought that was a really good line.
You know it. Oh, and he's got his lawyer Saul Goodman on speed dial, but you don't watch Breaking Bad, so you don't get that reference. Oh, and he's like,
I don't really watch TV in general.
He says, and it's as simple as this: on these minimalists, can I hang with the bar heavy lyrical shit? When I'm back up in the lab like kibbles and bits. That was a good line. And then he goes, and then he does that thing that Rap Critic hates. He's like, get it? Like Retriever? What the fuck? The dog? Labrador? No? I'm not.
I love the Macklemore line. I need a dollar. Did. Can you loan me some, Macklemore? I want them thrift shop checks so I don't care who I piss off next. Thought that was a really good line.
Speaking of y'all, dude, Macklemore, I listened to that Fuck Donald Trump remix again.
Dude, my
they put out a music video for it.
Macklemore, you
put out a music video for it, and it's just whatever, man. It's so weird. It's fucking YG, who whack, G-Eazy, who whack, and Macklemore. It's so awkward because YG think he tough. G-Eazy think he a faggot, and Macklemore think he just weird, and it's like the weirdest dudes that would never hang out with each other all in the video together, and I'm like, what the fuck, you talk about going to thrift stores in downtown, you think you a gangster, and the other dude think he a homo thug, I'm like, what is going on? I'm just like,
it's
what
weird
the
as
fuck?
Getting snow on the So Dope.
Oh my god. No, at least that one was so dope. I just thought that was weird, man. And then at the end of the music video, there's some like dude like fuck Donald Trump to some white dude, and the white dude was like, "What the fuck?" It was really weird. You gotta go watch it. Just skip
Let's
to the
move
end.
on with the current mixtape at hand, Fate.
I know, I'm just saying, man.
15 Outside the Box
With
featuring
Sincerely
Sincerely
Collins.
Collins,
Only other
produced
thing
by
I've
Jidah
heard.
on the track.
Only other thing I've heard by Sincerely Collins, he had Ritz and Jaren on a track. But I've seen his name before. He was flirted with Funk Volume for a little bit, and that was about it.
I have no
This is
idea
a good
who
song.
Sincerely Collins is. So.
Chris Webby's
Yeah, it's a
living.
good song.
He's living outside the box like a shipping address. Really good lyric. Even Collins
What
did
did
a
you
good
think of
verse.
Sincerely Collins' verse? Yeah, I was
It
gonna
was a really
say.
good verse. I liked his verse. I don't like. I mean, I don't really listen to him, but Webby and Collins did really, really good verses, and someone even commented that it was the best song off the mixtape. And I think it's a really good song. Not my favorite, but it's really fucking good though.
Yeah, not
So,
my favorite, but it is a really fucking good song.
just like a plausible, not plausible, a positive. There's the word. And he said you gotta stay on the mission like Ratchet and Clank. I love references, so that was really fucking awesome to hear. Don't get distracted by passing the drink. You reference fucking Ratchet and Clank, man, and that's awesome. Anything video game. Oh, and there was I really wanted to talk about this for half a second. So he says, okay, so he goes, man, where do I start to set? But I grab me a pistol and shot for the stars, and that bullet ain't stopping at Mars. So never let him try to stop who you are. Now, this is where I want to talk about it. He says, you could be a teacher, a doctor, a web technician, athlete, a barber, or a video vixen, tattoo artist, chef, or musician. Now, the rhyme scheme's clean. But I wanted to talk about, we're in 2016 where he listed being a web technician and even a video vixen as a possible career choice. I just thought that was interesting that it's bled into music that a web technician is now a viable job. I just thought that was weird. But I get it, I
Why did you think
respect
that
it.
was weird?
Because I don't know, how often do you hear your parents say, "Oh, you want to be when you grow up a lawyer or a doctor? Maybe you want to be a web technician?" No, you don't ever hear nobody say
That's
that to you.
true. That is
So it's just
true.
kind of weird that this generation of people see that as a real job,
I
even a
definitely
video
don't hear from
vixen.
my mom that I can be a video vixen,
Well, you being in one of those big
yeah.
Nicki Minaj music videos, one of those big rip dudes, would be Corey in the background. What's up, man? Oh, that's some good advice.
I
I
do good advice.
don't know. I honestly
Oh,
just thought that was a
God.
cool perspective on the times we live in that web technician is classified as like a job that's, and it's actually a good job too. It's always on like those lists that like Yahoo put out, 10 best career choices for the future, something like that, and something to do with the internet's always on it. So I just thought that was cool that it bled into music. It was really
I
cool.
love the line too, in my dojo, working and waiting to go pro. I thought that was a really good line as well.
You know it. These young virtuoso making my dough grow. On my solo, staying low, bro, or low pro. Anyways, and then Collins.
Numbers.
Hang on, Collins with a bunch of box wordplay. He's like, I remember when you boxed me and told me I could never leave the box again, and just a little me trying to find a real me, knowing that box was a crock of shit. The box had bots that would block the kid every time I shot from my rocket ship, but then I found the light and it showed me how to fight. So I'm saying we can box if you want to box me in. For real, I love the wordplay with the bar. I thought his verse was really good, and I don't really like him like that, but it was good. I'll give credit where credit's due.
It is a good verse. I've never really, I don't, I've never listened to him before, so I don't know anything about him. Anything else you want to say about that, or can we
No,
move
no,
on?
no. You move on. Let's go get high. Let's hang out with your dude, Lobster.
Number 16, High by the Beach, chilling with my homie Lobster, produced by JP on the track.
Who's
Video
my
was
dude?
so weird, man. Video was
Lobster
so
though. That
fucking
lobster
weird,
though, man.
man.
I thought it was funny the music video because they kept the lobster's claws tied up the entire music video. I was paying attention to that. I was like, they're gonna return that lobster. And they had to clip
Turn
his
that lot. They
claws.
bought it just for the video.
They borrowed that bitch, man. They thought that was
Oh
so funny,
God,
man. They didn't undo the
such a
claws. I pay
weird
attention to
music
shit like
video.
that. I like the
That's a
beat.
music video you watch only when you're high. And that's the only time it makes sense.
every time we about to get high, man, I always listen to this song. Like, oh, I'm about to go get high.
We're gonna have to start
get...
getting lobsters every time we
this
get high
shit
so we can talk
slump.
to them.
And the beat slump too, and it's about weed, and that's really about it. I mean, clever punchlines.
It's like
you
the
know.
Whole song's about weed, yeah. There's
but,
not
you know,
really much to say about this one, but it's slump.
I like the song, man. It's a good one. But, you know, clever punchlines, you know, Submerged Underwater by Davy Jones Locker. With shellfish and lobsters and an ancient sea monsters. You know, good fucking lyrics there and there, you know. Yep.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, you know.
He goes, fuck all the chemicals. So... up in the clouds, extraterrestrial. You hearing me now? Yeah.
Was that him or the lobster saying that?
I just like, yeah, it's a good song. Especially if you have to go smoke dude. Shit. Continuing.
Yeah, if you about to smoke that shit, you can listen to that song and it'd be alright.
It's a good one to slump in the background, man. I'm telling you. And that bass go in, I respect that bass.
Yeah, that beat is really good. Number 17, Cali Dreamin'. Produced by Jit on
Yo,
the Track. Or that's featuring Jit on the Track.
Yeah, he take that first verse too, man. So I always skip that shit. Respect to him. I like
that
the beat though.
Verse. It's so bad. first
I like
verse,
the beat, though.
I do not like at all. The beat is really good, but that first verse is bad.
There's a Star
he
Fox
says,
64
and
reference.
I quote, I wonder what would change my life. I wonder if I did not fight. I wonder if it don't vibe right. I'll make sure you go and spend your money.
I just skipped
and then
it,
he
man.
Says then he says this
now.
Can't believe it's a dream, I'm so blessed I know. Yeah, and away I go.
Sorry,
so
Jet. Stick to making those dope beats, but
stick to making the beats. Yeah, that beat
the beat's
is amazing.
Dope.
But that
the
verse
is
kinda
dope.
Meh.
So Corey, go ahead and tell about the Colorado plane and why we like this song because of that.
So the reason we've been bumping the hell out of this song is because we actually feel this type of song for the first time because we plan on moving out to Colorado and all getting a house together.
You know it.
And just chilling
straight
with
as
our
fuck.
Dudes and having a good time.
Yep.
And not having kids. That's the key. Can't have kids.
Kids have
not
babies.
Having kids, just chilling with our dudes, having a good time.
Make it C-play pregnant with that weed. Hey, weed.
So that's why we've been bumping the hell out of the song. That's why we like it so much. It's because we feel for the first time what he's saying. It's because we want to move too. We've been Colorado dreaming.
Remix.
That's why.
Remix.
Remix. Remix. Been Colorado
Remix.
Dreaming. But nah, I really like the song. It's a laid back song. Just with good references and wordplay here and there.
Sudoku, Star Fox 64.
Yeah.
Gotta go to
like
the in and out.
Sudoku got a whole lot of numbers to go through.
He needs just a microphone with Pro Tools.
Mm-hmm. Watching my expenses until I'm in the Benzes. Got the whole world on my friends list. Looking at life through my Ray-Ban lenses. Here to strike gold out west like I dreamt it. It's really good.
See, like this song should have been right next to Can't Complain, man. I don't understand, like. Why
yeah,
they,
it would.
They
that
put this album like this. I don't understand why they made the middle of the album amazing and then like kind of fucking flipped it, flopped it. Like, I don't get it. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. You'd have to ask them.
Like the first six tracks, I take excluding Ignition. I don't know. I don't know about the fucking way they did it. And then they end the album with a super. Like, really good song, but once it doesn't
Super
fit after Cali Dreamin'.
In depth, it does not fit after Cali Dreamin', no. We'll go ahead and move on to that one since it'll probably take a while to talk about. Last track, number 18, Chemical Romance. Does not go after Cali Dreamin' at all. They should have ended the album on Cali Dreamin'.
So, the first verse. Each verse talks about a different drug and what it's like on it and shit like that. Corey, who's Molly?
I can't seem to find Molly, so I don't know.
And who's Stacy? All right, so I get these two. Molly is Molly the drug, and I get and then Stacy's ecstasy. So I see what they did there. They took out the E, they made it Stacy. Now it becomes ecstasy. I see what they did there for this one. This one I got. Okay, I don't do Molly or this shit, so I can't relate to that subject matter. But I loved hearing his struggle through it and shit like that, and it was really fucking dope. And I love the way the verses go and the beat matches it. Oh,
I love how he set up this song. I love how he set it up.
Well, with the voicemails at the start of each verse.
Yeah, with the voicemail, and then he goes into the verse talking about his struggle with
Dear
it.
Dear Molly.
I love the way he set this song up. Even though him trying to do a girly voice kind of got on my nerves. Weird. But I love the strong structure. I love the way he set it up. And then the third verse, it's Xandra, which I can only assume he's talking about Xanax. It's the only thing that makes sense, is what I'm taking from
it. Hey, you're skipping the... So, I like how he mixes it up when he goes, like, angry. He's like, and your sister? That's my ex, Stacy. And both of you bitches are crazy. And I'm grown now. So listen, Molly. What I'm telling you is for you the best. Because when you I'm with... Oh, fuck. Because I'm a mess when I'm with
suck.
You. I like the how he gets all... like. Just amped up to do the verse, man. I just really like the energy, man.
Yeah.
And I like the way he ends at XOXO Christian Webster. I really like the way he did that. I really like the way he wrote this, man. That must have been awesome to write. He must have, like, wrote it like a letter or something, I bet. And, you know, just like, I don't know. It's fucking dope the way he did this. Really like this. This fucking song was, like, really 10 out of 10. This is, like, a perfect song also. Go on to the second one.
It is a really good song.
Dear Lindsay, I don't understand.
Dear Lindsay.
Go ahead. Mm-hmm. I don't understand.
You don't understand.
Who's
what?
Lindsay about?
I'm looking it up to see.
Oh, you gotta Google it to see if it's a reference?
That's what it says.
Okay, my bad. I knew this one. I don't understand the correlation. Is that like a nickname for it that people have had or something?
I don't know. I
you
don't
do a lot
do
of blow. Oh, shit.
Oh shit.
I hope you don't end up overdosing.
I know, right? Yeah, right, I don't know why it's Lindsay. I don't do drugs like
don't
that,
get it.
So I don't know.
I don't understand why he chose Lindsay.
I understood the drug once he started talking about it, but I didn't understand Lindsay.
Like he was a stripper. And that was a good tipper. They did it on a counter with a credit card.
Yeah, when he started talking about counter, I was like, okay, he's talking about coke, obviously.
Well, hopefully he doesn't put it in the microwave Lindsay. Or drop it in the carpet, though.
Yes,
yeah, we learned that from Ritz. We learned it from Ritz. So if it don't put it in the microwave, don't try to snort it at the carpet,
and don't let your girlfriend spill her coke on it.
Yeah, don't try to dry the cocaine. Don't like we've learned a lot of tips from
if
Ritz
you
on
do
how to deal
spill
with
it on the rug. You can snort it off the rug. Nobody's gonna think less of you.
Oh man. he talks about what it's like being
on cocaine.
I mean,
I would bump that song feels about weed, but yeah.
He talks about what it's like that he's anxious and angry. Where else? No. At first it was amazing until it wasn't. Then I'm crazy and I'm anxious and I'm angry and I lose sleep because you take me. And he goes in and... yep, and he did it. Where is it? There's
also
a lyric.
He talks about you hooking up with everybody at the after party, bitch. I know your repertoire. I love that.
So here's another deeper lyric everybody. That I really liked because it's interesting. This is like, I think about this lyric a lot for some reason. So he says, it was my 17th birthday, and that's when you took my virginity. And soon then later, I saw you on Fridays and saw you on Saturdays every week. So he was doing this while going to school, which means that I just thought into it like... But he only did it on Fridays and Saturdays. He didn't do it on the school nights, but he did it on the days off. I always thought about it like that. I took it one step further that he did it on those days, but he didn't do it every day. I just thought that was clever writing and interesting to see moderation and shit like that. Even though he hates it and stuff, you know, looking back on it, he still had the self-control still not to do it on every day, you know?
And most adults.
Unlike C Plant. Unlike C Plant, man.
Yeah, unlike C Plant. Yeah.
C Plant smoke all the time, though, but this dude don't do it Friday, Saturday, man. C Plant. So, anyways.
Anything else you want to say about C Plant?
And I like the way he is. He's like, don't bother trying to call. I've sank my last 8 ball, stepping away from the pool table once and for all. Okay. So,
yeah, really
moving on
good.
To the third verse.
Really
Xandra.
Good writing. Yes.
Who's Xandra?
I can only assume it's talking about Xanax.
Mm-hmm. I thought this one was about weed. From it.
Yeah,
are you
voicemail
sure?
Voicemail from, or.
I know it's about Xanax now, but I thought it was like weed too, because. I don't know. That's what I take away from it, because it reminds me of it. But I guess I don't smoke that sativa, so I guess that's why. Because when you smoke weed, you sit around, you play video games, and watch Netflix. And it makes you lazy, and then it makes you not do all the stuff you're wanting to do, and makes time slip by, and waking up at 2 p.m. I don't know, man. I'm just saying, that's reminding me of that weed, though, probably that doo-doo strain. So.
Yeah, only doo-doo weed makes you do that, Aaron.
Oh, my bad. Heard.
From our earlier experience from Sativa, that song.
Mm-hmm.
Only doo-doo weed makes you do that. But I can only assume he's talking about Xanax. Yeah, right here.
Well, yeah, it's Xanax, but yeah, I'm just saying, reminding me a little bit of that weed, though. But yeah, so, and then the third verse, different drug. That was fucking dope. And I like the flow, I like the beat, and that's pretty much the last song. Unless Corey got some other shit to say about this song.
There's a lot you can go in depth on each verse, but I mean, this song's super in depth, and it's a really good fucking song.
It's a great song.
Great song.
All right, Corey.
Like the fact that that's how they ended the mixtape, but what are you going to do?
Yeah, the track list is a little wonky. I thought it should have probably ended with Can't Complain and then followed up by Cali Dreamin' at the end. I don't understand.
Yeah, Cali Dreamin' would have been a better song, or Can't Complain would have been a better song to end the mixtape on, but what do you do? Nothing we can do. All we can do is sit here and talk about it on YouTube.
So you want to sit here and give a verdict on the album? Do it out of 10? What would you give it? Since we didn't
I'd
do
give it
events.
An 8 or so out of 10.
All right, so let's go back to Jared Benz real quick. Last week's episode of podcast, nobody watches, so fuck it, don't matter. People don't watch this anyways. So, Corey. We need to go back and do a verdict for Jaron Benton's. So, for Jaron Benton's Slow Motion, what would you give the album out of 10?
After listening so much, I'd give it an 8.5 or 9 out of 10. It's really fucking good. I'd give it a 9 out of 10. Really good, especially to see Jaron go deep into topics like that.
I don't know. It's
to see him either, go like that. To see
I know,
him
but
go like that is what gives me more on that. Like it's really good.
I say it's either like an 8.5 or a 9. I take off points.
That's what
because
I'm saying.
Anarchy is trash.
I do take off points because Anarchy is trash. Absolutely.
I didn't like the recycled fucking For Lost Kings, man. I heard that song last year, man. I didn't want that again. I didn't like.
It's a really good song though.
I didn't like What a Difference His Hook. Skirt, skirt, skirt. I don't like that dude. No Fucks to Give is so good. Like, the highs on the album are so fucking high, though. They make it up. So I'll give it a 9.
No Fucks to Give. Dark
I'd give
Jaron
a 9 for it.
Smash.
But just because of the highs are so high, man.
Yeah.
Fucking.
The low is very low, though. Anarchy doo-doo.
And so because of that, and then that brings us to Chris Webby because of his amazing verse. So for Webster's Laboratory, dude, get out of my laboratory. 2, what would you give it out of 10?
A 9 or a 9.5. I'd probably give it a 9.5, 9.5. Really fucking good. Well, I mean, if we're just going off of his verses, I'd be close to giving it a 10 because all of his verses were straight fire. If we're including the features, then I'd give it a 9.5 because there's some doo-doo features.
I think it's a 9.5.
But if we're just doing his verses, 9.5 to 10. His verses were really good.
It's a 9.5 because I take off points for... A little bit because of Knockdown, but I mean, there's no real beef with it, so I guess that's fine. On My Way, voice effect was a little annoying. Sativa, because I didn't care for the other dudes on it, but I mean, I guess that's preference. I didn't like the fucking way they structured the album. I don't like Questionnaire right in the middle of that shit for some odd reason. Like, I don't understand. I thought Inebriated and Imperfect should have been right next to each other because they both are really good songs that relate to each other.
Well, all the deep songs should have been right there in the middle of the album. Were they stuck, like...
Well, I mean, I get it. You don't want all deep songs because that'll just, like, kill you emotionally if you listen to it straight. I mean, I understand not putting them all together. Like, KOD split it up. You know, they didn't all... But a lot of them, like what was it, Pinocchio? What's the ones next to Pinocchio? Because they riffed off each other really well, though. Off KOD. And that's what I thought Webby should have did. Like, I think you should put two songs that relate to each other back to back. But I don't think you should put them all back to back. And KOD did it. KOD, let me pull the track list real quick. Because I still got that phone on. A song on my phone. Album on my phone. So he put Hunterish, which is about chicks. Then In the Trunk, which is about throwing a bitch in the trunk. Then talks about Pinocchio, which flows, these all flow together. Then Horns, which also flows off of those fucking, off of Pinocchio a lot. And then It Was an Accident, which flows even better off of fucking those last two tracks. I thought that was really well done. Low flows off of Killing You, Leave Me Alone. Like, they all flow really well off each other. I guess it's not really fair to compare because KOD was a themed album, but, you know, Black in the Sun and Strange Music Box played really well, and then Check Your Temperature. I mean, even B-Boy. So I guess it's not really fair to compare, but I'm just saying I prefer my album structure to be something similar where at least two of the tracks flow off each other, and they did not have that theme that much.
Yeah, they could have, Imperfect and Inebriated, they should have put those songs together.
Should have put Can't Complain and Cali Dreamin'. All right, so, but yeah, I'll give it a 9.5 then. You know, my gripes are very little when I look at it, think about it. So.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If we're talking about just Chris Webby, it was really good. If you're including the features and all that, then you start to take points off because some of the features are doo-doo. But overall, it's a really good mixtape, and I'd recommend it to anybody who likes this type of music, if you're not a faggot.
So, and the beats are really good. The punchlines are really good. The flow is getting better. You know, I wish you'd flow more. I think he can fucking flow like a motherfucker, too, man. I wish you'd flow more like that off some of these tracks.
He needs
to
start doing flows like UBI. Like, I feel like Webby would... Like, you know how UBI will, like, UBI flows really well, especially when he does his harmonizing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that type of shit. Like, I feel like Chris Webby would be really good at that.
Like his verse on the Jaren song... His verse, his fucking flow on Full Steam Ahead is really good. Like, I don't know, man. I think Chris Webby, man, I think he's really fucking good, man. I think he has a shit ton of potential. I don't think he's peaked yet either, because this is really good. This is a mixtape that was really good. And I listened to Chemically Imbalanced. I didn't think that was his opus yet. I still think he hasn't hit his peak yet. Like, after listening to that and listening to this, I still think there's a lot of potential there. I do think that Chemical Romance, I think Imperfect, are absolutely 10 out of 10 tracks. I think Inebriated is really fucking top tier. I think fucking Full Steam Ahead did dirty because he got Futuristic on it instead of somebody good. That would have made that song a lot better. Future, man, fucking Future, oh, this sounds like rock music mixed with heavy. Man, it don't sound like no rock music. What the fuck are you talking about, your baked ass, goofy looking self, man? Call of Duty playing Scrub. That's how I know you doodle. God, man. Ah, shit on you, dude, man. See me, I'm on Destiny, like, get doodled on, but you probably run around throwing self-res Warlock grenade spam over your shotgun and look a fellow with your life thorn using. Man, final round sniping, dude. You know, this dude is using one-man army noob tubes in COD, man. You know, Futuristic doodle.
Fucking dude, man.
Anyways. So, Corey, what'll be next week's podcast about? What album review next?
Hopefully top of the line if that ever happens.
I forgot about that. All right, we're gonna sign off for this too long. This is Big Gangster at 7 signing off with
BS Faggot.
There you go. Let us know in the comment section, dildo in the dildo section, all your thoughts on the album or what you'd rate it, best songs, shit like that. Maybe if you're a Futuristic fanboy, you know, tell us what I don't know how you're gonna do it. Fuck you.
A Futuristic fanboy.
Exactly. Peace out.